Now, if you see, this is only a one part of the sphere. There will be more such parts which will be behind this, something like this, below this, adjacent to this. So in total, this one part is nothing but first octant of sphere. There will be more seven octants of the sphere. Octants mean when we have the three dimensional figure, let's say this is our axis with negative part also. So when we have the three dimensional figure, one part is in the positive xy plane, one part in the negative xy plane. So two parts, first, second, third part will be here, fourth part will be here, fifth part will be below this, sixth part will be below this, seventh part will be below this, eighth part will be below this. So now total our xyz coordinate axis is divided into eight parts. So this we have done for only one part. So octant means eight. So this is the first octant of the sphere. Then we will have the seventh octants, which will be below this and adjacent to this part. So we have the seven octant. So this is the first octant of the sphere. So if you see, first octant of the sphere is going from this point till this point. That is, phi is going from 0 to phi when x and y axis are perpendicular to each other. So phi is going from 0 to pi by 2. Then we have angle theta. So this theta angle is going from this point till here. So theta is going from 0 to pi by 2. These are the limits for first octant of the sphere. To cover the full sphere, this phi will go from phi equal to 0 to entire this till here. So we will have phi equal to 0 to phi equal to 2 pi for entire sphere. Then this theta will go from this point till below, so that our entire sphere is covered. It is something like this. This phi will go from this point till this point. So we will get the circle in xy plane. Then we have the theta starting from z axis. It will go till here and this part will be covered. So theta will go from 0 to pi. So now if you see here, we have the limits for first octant and for full sphere. So you have to imagine phi is with respect to x axis and theta is with respect to z axis. To cover first octant, we will first move theta from this point till this point. Then we will move phi from here to here. So we get the first octant. Similarly, you will get the full sphere when we move phi is from 0 to 2 pi, that is this part, and from above to below. So that entire sphere is getting covered. So these are the limits which you have to remember, and we can directly write this limit. So this will be more clear when we see the problem on this type. So these are the basic substitution which we have to follow when we have the sphere given in our problem. So z is equal to r cos theta. So these are the basic substitution which we have to follow. And then we will also have dx into dy into dz. The dx into dy into dz in spherical coordinate will be r square sine theta dr d theta d phi. This is also a one substitution which we have to do. This will be more clear when we see the problem on this. So the problem on this we will see in our next video. So stay tuned for our future lectures.